Hey basketball players, my name is Alan from Al's Basketball Training, and today I'm going to talk to you about underhanded layups and how we should stop focusing on them when we're practicing and when we're training. Now this is more of a rant video because I've been seeing tons and tons of video from basketball trainers everywhere in the world, specifically here in Ontario around Toronto, who are teaching underhanded layups as their main layup. And they're making videos on this and it's bugging the hell out of me. And another trainer who I communicate with a lot, we're both really mad at this because when you're going for an underhanded layup, you're leaving the ball exposed like crazy. You know how many times I would block layups in high school when players went for underhanded layups? It's insane, and we should really stop learning these layups now. They do have a purpose. If you can actually jump high enough to touch the rim, you can do what's called a floater, or you can do like a finger drop. There's many different words for it. But if you can jump that high, you can just lay the ball in and have it bounce or roll in off your hands. However, if you're in a game and you're in a game where there's going to be help defenders coming off onto you, there's a reason why you're gonna get that layup blocked. So yes, this is more of a rant video, but this is a really good explanation as to why we shouldn't be doing and are really focusing on underhanded layups. Because when you're going for an underhanded layup, you're going like this. Here's some video right now. But when you're going in for those layups, you've got defenders around you no matter what. And if you're going in for an underhanded layup like this, you're leaving the ball exposed to get blocked. And believe me, if I'm playing against you, if I was still in high school, I would be blocking that up to the 12th row because it's such a weak layup. Now, what you really want to do at the very least, if you're going to do a one-handed layup, is at least have it above your head. That at least cuts down on some of the players who are able to block the shot. Next, what you would be ideally doing is going up with two hands all the way up to the top and then finishing with one. The reason for this is because if you get contact on you, so let's say you're going in for a layup underhand, they don't get the ball, but they hit your arm, you've now missed the layup. Now, if they hit your body, you're not really in control of the ball, so you're gonna lose the ball and they may or may not call that a foul because it's on your body, depending on the referee. So that's number one reason why you shouldn't be going in for underhanded layups. Number two, at least when you're going above your head, you're still not really in control of the ball, but at least it cuts down on players who are hacking away lower end for the ball. But if they still hack your arm, you're losing that ball. Now third, if you go up with two hands, if you're going up with two hands with that layup, if they hit one of the hands, at least you'll still have a second hand on the ball. But also, it's putting pressure on the ball. If you're going up with two hands, it's going up, and you're going to be able to go up with two hands. And even if they do hit your arm, you're in a lot more stable of position because you're clamping down on the ball. You're not just going up really weak like this, able to get hit and have it bounce out of your hand. If you go up with two arms or two hands on the ball, and if you get hacked, because you've got pressure on that ball to hold on to it, you're gonna be able to withstand a lot more of the hit when you're going up for that left-handed layup. But if you go up two hands and then one hand at the end, you're gonna be a lot more stable. You're gonna get a lot more and one shots. So if you make a layup and get fouled, you can get your third point from the free throw line. But if you go up, get fouled, one hand and have it hit out of your hand, then it's not going to be an and one. You're just gonna be getting two shots from the free throw line. And let's face it, I would much rather hit a layup and get a third point than miss a layup and get 2 points. Another thing that I've seen with basketball players and trainers is they're teaching reverse layups like this, where they go like this and around, kind of like the Dr. J kind of hook shot or hook dunk that he does. That's all good if your hands are half the size of the basketball like Dr. J, but if you're a kid and you're going up uncontrolled like that, you're not going to be making that layup, especially if you get hit. You need to go up with two hands. And that's what I mean by two hands. Go up with two hands, finish with one, and you're gonna have a lot more control of a layup. I hope that this video has helped you, and make sure if your trainer is teaching you underhanded layups, I think it's time for you to find a new trainer. I'll see you guys again tomorrow for another Twice a Day basketball video.